What is up, guys? My name is Thaddeus, and today's video is gonna be like super short. But what I wanted to talk about, as I've seen a few people in the comments actually mention this and asking about it, is, you know, either AliExpress blocks your card or your bank blocks your card, right? And like what you can do to actually go about that and fix the problem, okay? So that's what we're gonna talk about today. I have nothing else to say besides, you know, thank you guys for the support. So far we're at like 5,500 something subscribers. That's crazy. And yeah, let's get started. All right, 3, 2, 1, let's go. My hair game has been kind of whack, so I got the hat on and I got the shades on inside. You guys know what's up. Okay, so from when I first started, right, and the, like when you guys start seeing volume and orders come through and you start ordering them off AliExpress, a few things kind of like, one, it can go through fine. Everything's dandy, like good stuff, right? No speed bumps, nothing trying to block your success. But there's other issues that, you know, the bank will see a bunch of these orders come through, you know, and you're ordering to different countries and different locations, so they think your card's getting like hacked or something like that. So they shut it down, they block it, and you know, the orders don't go through, which is a problem, okay? Or the other side, the other half of it is like AliExpress can actually like put a hold on your account as well, because they see all these orders going from different locations and stuff like that. The AliExpress one is actually a pretty, like, there's a very clear-cut fix for that. So if AliExpress is blocking you from like ordering for your clients and stuff like that, what you can do is you hit up their support. Their support's ass, by the way, okay? It's terrible. Like, you're talking to a robot, by the way, if you don't know that. It's just like a smart AI. And you gotta complain. You gotta pretend to be super pissed, okay? This is like, I talking like all caps. You're gonna talk to them and be like, I can't order for my clients or something like that, okay? And you're gonna get through to an actual like real person, and then they're gonna hit you with please like verify your AliExpress like credit card, okay? So you're gonna put like a primary card on file that they can verify, and then they won't have to like hold or block your orders because they know like it's you and it's all going through you. But you don't want them to do the normal way. The normal way is when you'll get an automated message saying, you know, hey, verify your card so that all these orders go through, and then you go to their website and they want you to submit documents and stuff like that to their own like to the site, and then submit the like the application to appeal or something like that, right? That's what you don't want to do, okay? You do that and it's gonna take forever for them to actually approve it. What you do is you go tell to the support guy, you've been like, all right, my card's blocked, I need to verify my stuff. What is the email that I can send all my documents to, because like the actual site's not working, okay? That's what I said. And then they're gonna hit you with an email. I'm 99% sure the email is like security@aliexpress.com. I could be wrong, so like again, just hit up their support team because I don't know what the fuck it is. You do that. Then in the email you tell them like, all right, this is all my information. I think you have to send them your ID, a bank statement that shows AliExpress orders going through, and your credit card, like a picture of your credit card and stuff like that. So you're gonna have all those documents attached. You're gonna email them, and then after you email them, again, they take like 3 to 5 days. And like when I first started, I didn't have 3 to 5 days to wait. Okay, I had to order every single, because I was like, I was tripping out. I was like, holy shit, I have too many orders going through. I don't want, you know, people like these are extra days that someone might like do a chargeback or something if they don't get their product like very quickly, or as quickly as you can with AliExpress dropshipping, right? And so I'm tripping out. Then you hit up their support team again. You've been like, all right, I emailed the security team. I haven't got a response yet. I would do this after a day, not like right after you submit the documents. Okay, after a day, you've been like, I need this verified like now. And then you make it like tell them like to put it as a priority. That's what you do. Then they're like, okay, we'll do it. And you just gotta act pissed, even if you're not. Like, I was just chilling on my laptop, like on my laptop right there. I was just chilling, and you just gotta act pissed out of your mind. And that's how you get them to like verify your card quickly on AliExpress. Now with the bank, it's a little different, and I don't know like everyone's situation, just because I don't know all these different banking companies that you can go through. I use Wells Fargo for mine. If you're using Wells Fargo, then like dope. But what they do is they have like it's almost like Instagram. I make all my like a lot of my money through Instagram. But they use machine learning to like block like automated bots and stuff like that. And that's what like Wells Fargo does to like detect if something is like fraudulent or something's like not being placed through you. And seeing a shit ton of AliExpress orders going to different countries, like that's gonna raise a red flag, especially if you're just starting off dropshipping, right? Like they haven't seen this before. They're like, what the fuck is this? They're gonna put a block on your card. You gotta call them to release the hold, and then you gotta wait like an hour, a few hours or something, and then you can order again. And then they put a block on your card like the next day. Like, I was on the phone every single night with my bank guys. What you wanna do to fix that, right? I mean, you gotta call them every single night so that like you tell them like, all right, these are all my orders, you verify the orders and you tell them that's yours. It took me, I think, 3 weeks of being on the phone every single night with their support guys until it finally stopped kind of like putting them as red flags, and like the machine learning, whatever they want to call it or advertise it as, like learned that shit wasn't fraudulent, okay? There's a few ways to go. Like, I mean, one way is just like dealing with that bullshit. Like, you gotta just call them every single night for 3 weeks. You hop on the phone for like 20 minutes, verify everything, you're like, all right, I was done for the day. Awesome. I'll see you tomorrow. Literally, that was my phone call was with I think her name was like Janelle or something. Okay, that was it. What you can do on Oberlo, I know Oberlo's like dropping some new stuff, like Oberlo Supply. There's that for dropshipping. I know it's a little bit more expensive than if you just like do purely dropshipping from AliExpress. But Oberlo Supply, you can order everything in one click. So instead of a bunch of like tiny orders coming through on your bank statements and on your credit card, you're ordering all your products for that day or however long you choose to fulfill orders for. So like all the orders for the day, you can order them in one click. And so instead of like a bunch of like $5, $10, $2 charges on AliExpress going to your bank statement, you get like one like $600 charge, and it doesn't come up as like fraudulent, right? Because it's just one charge. It's not like a shit ton of these like it's not like 50 charges coming in for the day that are super super small going to different countries and shit and whatnot, right? So that's one way to fix it. That's if you're using Oberlo Supply. If you're not using Oberlo, that's fine. Honestly, just the legalities of this like drop shipping with AliExpress is that like banking is all risk, right? They don't want to lose money. They don't want to they don't want you to file chargebacks and stuff like that. They need to build relationships with their clients who use their cards. It's a very complicated industry. Oh my god, I almost knocked over my Red Bull. I actually put this on top of my car yesterday and like it like cracked and like fell off because I forgot to take it off the roof of my car and I drove away. But I still picked it up because I ain't trying to lose Red Bull, bro. What am I talking about? Okay, so that's the fix, guys. AliExpress, you do the verification, you go through the security like email, and that's how you get it verified like as quickly as possible. For banking, you can be on the phone with your guys. Like again, I don't know, like some of you guys use like Chase or like USA Bank, or like, I don't know what you use, right? But at least for Wells Fargo, that's it. I was on the phone every single night for like the first 3 weeks, calling. And then on AliExpress too, if you're not using Oberlo Supply, there is a way. I showed my VAs this a while back, but you can when you add all the products to cart, right, and you input all the information, you just don't go through with the order yet. You open another tab and then you go through all like the next customer's orders, right? If you do all of that and then the last one, you'll have all the orders going to different addresses, right? And then you fulfill, like you purchase it. That's one way of doing all the orders at once in one payment instead of like a bunch of small charges. So you can look into that, like if you choose to. Like if you just don't want to have to deal with the bank, that's one way to bypass it. It's just like kind of complex because you're opening like 1,000 different tabs and it can get very, very confusing, especially if you fuck up. That's a problem, okay? So that's the super quick video, guys. Like if AliExpress blocks your card, you know what to do, right? You go to security@aliexpress.com or whatever email they give you, right? Well, first of all, you throw a shit fit to their support team, to their bot, so you can talk to a real person. You throw a shit fit to them, get the email address for the verification, you send an email to them with all the documents that you need, then you wait a day, then you like, you know, get more upset at the support team so that they put you on priority, because you know they need to please their dissatisfied customers. So they put you on as priority, you get your card verified, you don't have to worry about AliExpress blocking your card. Just make sure you don't ever cancel that card or like switch cards or something like that, because then you have to repeat the whole thing again and it kind of sucks. Now for banking, you might be on the phone for the next few weeks with like every single night trying to just be like, all right, yeah, this AliExpress charge is mine, yes, correct, all that kind of stuff, so that they can verify it, and then like their machine learning knows that it's you placing those orders. Or, you know, if you're using Oberlo Supply to dropship, you can fulfill them all at once. Again, that's a little bit more expensive than actual just purely AliExpress Shopify dropshipping with Oberlo. But the other thing is, you know, open up a different, like a bunch of different tabs for each customer while you're fulfilling orders. So you fulfill one, but you just don't pay for it. So you add it all to cart, get the information done, open a new tab, do the next customer, add to cart, you know, get the information done. And then at the very end, you order it all and it goes off to everyone. But that one's just very easy to like mess up on. I might just make a whole like individual video on that and put it in my course. The support for the course has been amazing, guys. Thank you so much. I'm gonna throw like some screenshots or something of people's comments that have like shown the love on the YouTube channel as well. Just being like, yo, this course is awesome, blah, blah, blah. Screenshot. Okay, cool. Now, if you are in the course, there's a 25% discount, link in the description. Always plug. You guys know I gotta like, I'm honestly getting pretty good like with these plugs and stuff. Red Bull. That's the video, guys. Leave a like, comment, subscribe. I respond to everyone's comments like dead ass. You can check the course video out if you haven't already, but you can look at the comment section. I respond to everyone, even some of the haters, because it's kind of fun talking some sense to them, because there's been a few that they talk smack. I respond, they're like, oh my gosh, you responded. Can I learn from you? And okay, but that's the thing, guys. Thank you for your support. We'll see you guys at 10,000 subscribers and beyond. Subscribe to the lifestyle channel, subscribe to the vlog channel. The link is all in the description. If you haven't even started on Shopify yet, like, what are you doing, dog? Like, there's links and all that stuff there too. Always plug. But yeah, like, comment, subscribe, guys. Thank you for your support. I will see you guys in the next video the next day, which is tomorrow. Sounds good. Take care, guys. Peace.